it can be nice to build up on top of flat color with some other variations. But the first hardest step of digital coloring is finding the right local flat color. And I'm close. So this was my flatting color. And this is my flat local color, but Photo-P isn't being that responsive. So what I'm going to do is save it. And there it is. And then I'm going to reopen Photo-P and close a lot of these tabs I don't need open. All right, now if I open Photo-P, it should run a little bit better. And of course, you could do the same process in Photoshop with the same PSD file. Whoops, that's not the right one. Where is it? This is the right one. All right, because that PSD file has my big sandwich, right? And now I'm layering it up in different ways. So I am finding better colors slowly and surely. Let me continue. All I need for this in Photo-P is underneath the gradient tool, the paint bucket, and to hold down option to steal colors. So now I'm going to use my inspirations and find a good green. So let's go with the Honey Smacks frog. My God, that's a bright green. Whew. And if it's a little much, maybe I'll go to this guy. It's illustration of Odin. It's a little bit better. Or maybe I want something in between those two, right? Huh? So I think actually the closest one I want is this, but now I'm going to modify it. So I'm just going to take it down a notch. And maybe lighten it. There we go. Okay. Now what about the feet? Maybe I can use this same color. So hold down option, steal that color, drop it in for the feet. Yeah. Do I miss the orange? A little bit, but maybe I can add that in with duotones. Then what about the talons? Let's steal the color from the eyeball and just put that right into the talons. Okay, and then what about the helmet? Maybe modify this, just brighten that up. Maybe warm it up a little. Yeah, that works. And then what about this highlight? Maybe use the white of the eye for that. Or maybe even, I think that's what I had before. All right. And then this green. This is now hinting at duotone, though it's not quite duotone because it is separated by lines. But now I have a different tone of green. There we go. And now that blue doesn't quite make sense in the helmet. So what can I do? Let's modify it. Select it. Let's gray that out. Maybe bring it a little bit more towards purples. Purplish gray. It's a little bit darker. And then drop that in. Remember, you can always do Command Z. Now, this is the only place I have this brown. Can I use it anywhere else? Maybe not yet. All right. So I think, oh yeah, I will. I'll use this brown on these. And then I'll use this darker gray on this. So it's really easy to just swap in the colors you want once you've already filled them in. So these were my flatting colors, and then these are my local flat colors. And the only one that didn't change is that main body and then the eyeball, that kind of bright purple eyeball and the pink of the tongue. Certain things were kind of nice to keep. Okay, what about this blue? Feel like I should revisit it. Let's use this one. See how that looks. This is just processing slowly. Okay, yeah, I like that better. All right, good. Now, if you did a good job with your local flat color, it looks very believable. And I'm going to lighten that green a little bit. Keep tweaking. So it looks very believable, but it doesn't look necessarily inspiring, right? Or eye-catching. Just like in my exhaustive explanation slides, flat color can often look less interesting than flatting because it's got less diversity to it. So then what's the next step to make it more interesting? After local flat color, now you can play with duotone. And duotone is adding lights and darks within each flat color. So just to be really clear, this can work as a finished color solution. And I'm going to go ahead and save this. Like I saved my flatting colors. Now I'm going to save my local flat color by turning off everything else and exporting it as a PNG. And instead of it being full color, this is what's called local flat color. Flat because it's one solid pixel throughout the shape. Local because now that color is the color that the thing actually is. Like a yellow for a banana, no matter the light condition. And if I was being a real like stickler for flat color, all the blues would be the same on his body, but that's just a little too much. Charlie Brown in Peanuts comics, Sunday comics, right? They're done with flat color, just local flat color. It doesn't matter if Charlie Brown is outside at night or inside or on the train tracks during the day with a train barreling on him. His shirt is always that same yellow. His skin color is always that same skin color. His shoes are always that same brown. What if we wanted to make it more dimensional? Let's look up a 3D Charlie Brown. Ooh. To do that, now we have to add light conditions to those local colors. So he's going to have variations of light and dark yellow, variations of light and dark skin tone, variations of light and dark brown. Doesn't always look good, but that's what duotone does, right? Oh, I like this one. Ooh, this is a 3D model you can buy for $25. Very nice. Now, do you think it's licensed? I'm guessing it's not licensed, but maybe it's transformed enough that it can be original. But it's gutsy to call it Charlie Brown. I like it, though. It's fun. Anyway, okay. It's a good reminder that you can do pixel-based coloring within 3D models as well. 3D models are vectors, but each polygon is filled with pixels. Just like we're filling in between the edges of our vector line art with our pixel color. All right, so I've saved this. Here it is. If I want, I can put that up into the assignment. because I like it better than my flatting colors. As long as you have some color solution, you are meeting the requirements. And as a PNG, it should look good on a white background, on a gray background, on a black background. That means it would look good on a t-shirt. Okay. So, what's next? Duotone. Just like we saw with Skylar, these were the full flat colors, and then this was the full duotone. And this is hard edge duotone, also known in animation as cell shading. And there are so many ways we can vary this. And if you're looking at different ways to push your coloring, if you look under assignments, under assignment 5, which is this assignment, you'll see my exhaustive explanation on digital coloring, but you'll also see a bunch of past student presentations on ways to play with digital coloring, all of which use slightly different approaches for different kinds of finishes. And then I give you this one professional example, which is really common now among freelance artists, using this 1970s Japanese Xerox technique called risograph, which uses two different colors of toner and gives you kind of an original one-of-a-kind print with each layer until it all layers up into the finished image. And you can imitate that digitally. So just all kinds of ways. But right now we just have basic flat color. So what's next? I'm going to duplicate that flat color. This is the way I like to play with duotones. And I'm going to change the name of that flat local color copy. I'm going to change it to highlights. And this will be duotone hard edged. So how do I make highlights? Well, I just copied the flat color. The way I make highlights is I just go to Image, Adjustments, Levels, and I take that mid-tone slider and I push it to the left. Basically adds white to all of my colors, gives me a pastel version. I like to do this on the gray background. And then if I keep my flat color underneath it, it should just be a brighter version of those flat colors. Like if I'm shining a bright light on all those flat colors. Then what do I do to make it duotone? I use my lasso because this is cut edge. I'm going to give it just a 1 pixel feather just to soften it a little bit. And I'm going to cut out the shadows. So the underside of the foot here, you can use your mouse for this. You can use your tablet. I'm going to work within the line art. And I'm using my tablet here. And I am going to physically lasso and cut out from my highlights, the only one that's unlocked, the shadows. Because when I delete them, it shows the flat color underneath. So if I know this wing is casting a shadow on the body and on the foot, I can cut that out. Why do I like to use the lasso? Because I can modify selections with the lasso. I can hold down Option. Not doing a great job. And I can put it right underneath the line art. And then delete. And remember, I'm not affecting the black lines at all. The black lines aren't even there. They're just hovering above. So this is adding tone into my sheets of colored glass behind the leading. And I love this method. And though you're not required to do duotone, I hope you'll play with it, because I think you'll like it. Even when it's really subtle.